Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, greetings. My name is David. Welcome indeed to the Sprig and Fern Petone charity quiz, truly the best quiz this side of Texas. Thanks to all those who tuned in and watched our first online lockdown quiz last week. We've had a lot of people tune in from their bubbles and enjoy the quiz, and we've even had some great feedback, like this from James. James says, where did you get your tie? I'm sorry, James, it's a state secret. Or this from Susan, wow, you're really balding. Thanks, it's great feedback, really helpful. Please keep it coming. The Sprig and Fern Petone runs their weekly quiz as a charity fundraiser. And last week, I asked those who took part in the quiz if they could please make a donation to the Wellington Down Syndrome Association, a wonderful local volunteer organisation who provide information and resources to parents, families and health workers to support them in helping those with Down syndrome. We raised nearly $200 from our quiz last week, which is just incredible. Wellington Down Syndrome Association is truly thankful, and you get another chance this week to donate to them again if you haven't done so already. Please check out their account details in the video description below, and please make a donation. And without much further ado, let's get quizzing. Let's crack straight into things with round one, general knowledge, and question number one. Left out of the Hollywood film version, Tom Bombadil was an important character from which book series? Left out of the Hollywood film version, Tom Bombadil was an important character from which book series? And question two. The name of which weekday stems from a one-handed Norse god of war? The name of which weekday stems from a one-handed Norse god of war? Sounds like he needs to go to a second-hand shop. Question three then, and it's the first multi-choice question of the quiz. Hey. Which 1975 film was the first movie to earn more than $100 million at the box office? Was it A, The Rocky Horror Picture Show, B, Jaws, or C, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest? Which of those 1975 films was the first movie to earn more than $100 million at the box office? Was it A, The Rocky Horror Picture Show, B, Jaws, or C, One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest? Question four is for all you home chefs out and about. Butter, flour, and milk are the three key ingredients if you are making what type of sauce? Butter, flour, and milk are the three key ingredients for making what type of sauce? Question five of round one, general knowledge, and it's multi-choice. The name of which of the following buildings stems from the Greek word for royal? The name of which of the following buildings stems from the Greek word for royal? Is it A, embassy, B, casino, or C, basilica? Which of the following buildings stems from the Greek word for royal? A, embassy, B, casino, or C, basilica? And here is a question six, which is multi-choice as well. The Right Honourable Jacinda Ardern, New Zealand's very own Prime Minister. Please can you tell me her middle name? Is it A, Kate, B, Laurel, or C, Elizabeth? Jacinda Ardern, the New Zealand Prime Minister, what is her middle name? Is it A, Kate, B, Laurel, or C, Elizabeth? To question seven. According to the movie Shrek, what vegetable is an ogre most like? According to the movie Shrek, what vegetable is an ogre most like? You'd be right, pumpkin, if you don't know that. To question eight. What is the name of the most populous country in South America? What is the name of the most populous country in South America? Question nine now, and good news, it's multi-choice. Where is the smallest muscle in the human body located? Is it A, the ear, B, the eye, or C, the brain? Where is the smallest muscle in the human body located? A, the ear, B, the eye, or C, the brain? And let's finish round one, general knowledge, with question 10. School is back up and running with children doing lots of online learning and no doubt busy sending out loads of online assessments to children around the country. The Minister of Education here in New Zealand, please can you tell me their name? The name of the New Zealand Minister of Education. Well, that's it for round one. We're moving along to round two, which is our picture round. You're going to be seeing 10 images appear before you. They are going to be of celebrities or characters wearing masks because it's COVID season and we have to protect ourselves, right? Well, some of these characters just, I don't think they get it. Well, they're taking it too serious. Anyway, your job is to check out these pictures, name the characters that you see, and have a bunch of fun.
Have you ever worn a mask? Yeah. One, two, one, two.
M to the A to the S to the K. Put the mask on the face just to make it next day. Feds be hawking me, jokers be stalking me. I walk the street and camouflage my identity.
My posse in the Brooklyn wear the mask. My crew in the Jersey wear the mask.
M to the A to the S to the K. Put the mask on the face just to make it next day. Feds
be hawking me, jokers be stalking me. I walk the street and camouflage my identity. My posse in the Brooklyn wear the mask. My crew in the Jersey wear the mask.
M to the A to the S to the K. Put the mask on the face just to make it next day. Feds
be hawking me, jokers be stalking me. I walk the street and camouflage my identity. My posse in the Brooklyn wear the mask. My crew in the Jersey wear the mask.
That's it for our picture round. Moving along then to our mystery round today. Ooh, what's it going to be? With lockdown, the TV's been on lots and lots, and I'm sure for some of our households, there's been cartoons on and on and on, and you're probably over it, but we're going to have a question round full of cartoon trivia. So question number one, Dewey, Huey, and Louie were the nephews of which famous Disney character? Dewey, Huey, and Louie were the nephews of which famous Disney character? Cartoon Mania question number two. What was the name of the cartoon cat who constantly tried to eat the canary called Tweety Pie? What was the name of the cartoon cat who constantly tried to eat the canary called Tweety Pie? To question three. What was the name of the town where Wilma and Fred Flintstone lived? What was the name of the town where Wilma and Fred Flintstone lived? Question four. One of Bambi's friends was called Thumper. What type of animal was Thumper? One of Bambi's friends was called Thumper. What type of animal was Thumper? Moving to question five. What was the name of the big brown bear who protected Mowgli in Walt Disney's The Jungle Book? The name of the big brown bear who protected Mowgli in Walt Disney's The Jungle Book. Cartoon Mania question number six. From the Disney movie Aladdin, what was the name of the pet parrot of the bad guy Jafar? From the Disney movie Aladdin, what was the name of the pet parrot of the bad guy Jafar? Question seven. Name the cartoon character who was known as the fastest mouse in all Mexico. Name the cartoon character who was known as the fastest mouse in all Mexico. Question number eight. Who was Popeye's chief opponent who tried to woo Olive Oil away from her spinach eating boyfriend? Who was Popeye's chief opponent who tried to woo Olive Oil away from her spinach eating boyfriend? The penultimate question then of today's Cartoon Mania quiz round. Question nine, which cartoon character was featured in the short Steamboat Willie? Which cartoon character was featured in the short Steamboat Willie? Question number 10 to finish off today's mystery round. Bart Simpson has two sisters. What are their names? Bart Simpson has two sisters. What are their names? Let's move on into our next round, which is our music round. We're all stuck in our bubbles, but we still need to be exercising, some of us more than others. What better way to exercise than with some epic exercise jams playing along with us? You're about to hear 10 snippets of music. You have to name the artist or the band and the name of the song and do some exercise while you're listening. Hit it, DJ.
Work it, make it, do it, makes us harder, better, faster, stronger.
Body moving, body moving, body moving, we be body moving, body moving, body moving, body moving, we be body moving.
Well, after all that exercise music, you probably think you've done enough for a break. Well, no. We have another round today, and it's round five, sports. It's sports round. Sports. Time for some sports. We have 10 questions of sports coming your way, and we're going to start with question number one, which is multi-choice. In judo, black belt is ranked the highest colored belt. What is the second highest? Is it A, red, B, blue, or C, brown? In judo, black belt is ranked the highest colored belt. What is the second highest? Is it A, red, B, blue, or C, brown? Red, blue, and brown. I'm pretty sure they're primary colors. Sports question number two. The Olympics have moved to the year 2021. Athletes who finish first, second, and third receive a gold, silver, or bronze medal, respectively. Athletes who finish 4th to 8 receive a what? Is it A, a certificate, B, a diploma, or C, a pat on the back? Athletes who finish 1st, 2nd, and 3rd receive a gold, silver, or bronze medal respectively in the Olympics, but athletes who finish 4th to 8th receive a what? Is it A, a certificate, B, a diploma, or C, a pat on the back? Question number three. What is the name of the popular school playground game with four players on a square court divided into quadrants? What is the name of the popular school playground game with four players on a square court divided into quadrants? Please note, regardless what it's called, the game is purely voluntary in participation. Question number four is a multi-choice question. Kiwi driver Hayden Paddon drives what brand of car in the World Rally Championship? Kiwi driver Hayden Paddon drives what brand of car in the World Rally Championship? Does he drive A, a Peugeot, B, a Hyundai, or C, a Toyota? A Peugeot, a Hyundai, or a Toyota? Sports.
Sport.
Question number five. How many points is awarded for a penalty try in a game of rugby union? How many points is awarded for a penalty try in a game of rugby union? Sports question number six is multi-choice. In the year 2005, in what sport did Scotland become world champions? Was it A, curling, B, elephant polo, or C, haggis eating? In the year 2005, in what sport did Scotland become world champions? Was it A, curling, B, elephant polo, or C, haggis eating? And question seven of a sports variety. To the game of baseball, during a game, how many players are there in each team? In the game of baseball, during a game, how many players are there in each team? Sports question number eight. The 1st of February, 1981. A very dark day in the history of the cricket competition between New Zealand and Australia. What is the name of the Australian player who bowled the underarm bowl? What is the name of the Australian player who bowled the underarm bowl? And no, he wasn't using sandpaper at the time. The penultimate question of the sports round and the penultimate question of today's quiz. What is the regulation height of a netball hoop in feet? What is the regulation height of a netball hoop in feet? And the final question of the sports round. Kiwi driver Scott Dixon
Sport.
Is currently competing in the E-Series IndyCar iRacing Championship. On Sunday morning in the Firestone 175, Scott Dixon finished in what place? Was it A, first, B, second, or C, third? On Sunday morning in the Firestone 175, Scott Dixon finished in what place? Was it A, first, B, second, or C, third? And that's a wrap for this week's Sprig and Fern Petone Charity Lockdown Quiz. I hope there's been some good fun competition between those of you in a bubble. And if you've done it by yourself, then congratulations. It seems you've won. Please do make a donation towards the Wellington Down Syndrome Association. Check out their account details in the video description below. And good news to all you Sprig and Fern Petone fans out there. When we move to level three, they are aiming to provide a takeaway and delivery service, which is fantastic because I've run out. Keep an eye on their Facebook page for more details. And don't forget, you can support the Sprig and Fern Petone by buying a voucher from them via the SOS Business website. Check out the video description below for details. Thanks everyone for joining in. Till next week, stay safe in your bubbles and remember to be patient and be kind.
When I was young, it seemed that life was so wonderful. A miracle, oh it was beautiful, magical. And all the birds in the trees.
Alright, I've got my shirt, I've got my vest. Which tie am I going to wear? Oh, classic. That's it then for round one. Let's crack on into round two. And it's our pick. Which one are you thinking, Ted?
You like the orange one? Good choice. Good choice.
Oh, it's not hard. Come on, you stupid.